to Fight, Foxtrot, India, Tango, Echo, Sierra, direct Honolulu.
Alright, Jet Dust 253, clear present possession, direct Finke, Weed, 2700 North, 13000 West, 2400 North, 13600 West, Beaumont, R5.
So this is gonna be annoying, man, with no cell call this entire time.
All the way across the year.
I mean, we're gonna be listening to the cell call chimes screaming at us. I mean, I'm gonna have such a headache. The good news is there's not that much radio traffic between after Honolulu, but it's gonna be pretty brutal for this leg for sure.
The return of 341, also known as Kawara Beach, started off in the Southern California desert, Victorville to be exact, and I had Rico along, so I knew this would be a fun one. We showed up at noon for a 1 p.m. departure, and of course, the airplane wasn't quite ready. The final weigh-in was still in progress, and the FAA inspector wanted to see the engines run one more time to clear a nuisance fault that had popped up the night before departure. We spent a good solid 4 hours on the ground there, first in the cafeteria eating vending machine potato chips and overdosing on sugary drinks, and then sitting on the airplane and wandering aimlessly around the ramp. The mission for the day would be pretty simple. Get to Honolulu and then go into 12 hours of rest. This was actually the sixth of the aircraft we brought back to Australia from the original seven, so the trip logistics have become extremely routine.
Sure.
Yeah, we're waiting for the logbook.
Oh, are you?
Yeah, as soon as we get it, we're ready. As a matter of fact, we were filed out 5 minutes ago, so.
Gotcha.
Yeah. Oh, okay. Yeah, well, I mean, do you need me out of here right now, or? My hope is like 10 minutes.
10 minutes.
Yeah, I'm going to text them and find out status of the logbook. So,
cool, man.
All right, brother.
They wanted to move us somewhere elsewhere,
but I mean that would be silly considering we're hopefully leaving.
Where do you want to
go? Over by the 777s. I guess we're in the middle of the way.
Like the penny-pinching misers that we are, we scheduled a quick hop down to San Bernardino to top off for the haul over to Oahu. This flight would take about 10 minutes. A 10-minute up and down in a 737 is really busy, so we got our heads in the game and buckled down to work. Like Victorville, which is just a few miles north, San Bernardino is home to a lot of aircraft and dry storage too. Like the rest of these places, Bernardino is absolutely stuffed to the gills with lines of jets. We took about 4,000 gallons of Jet A and got the plane turned in just about an hour.
We're going super sophisticated here with the catering today. Baked Lays, Dunkin' Donuts coffee. Well, Thin Mint Girl Scout cookie Dunkin' Donuts coffee. All right, you're clear to turn to At Your Leisure.
In no time at all, we were back underway on the last leg of the day, which would take us out over the Pacific Ocean, heading straight for Honolulu. Although the airways between California and Hawaii are some of the busiest oceanic corridors in the world, you wouldn't know it from the cockpit. There's no radar coverage out over the ocean, and ATC communications take place over HF radios. On overland routes, pilots are in continuous communication with air traffic controllers and are largely visible on their ATC radar consoles. When out over the open ocean, the controllers rely on position reports made at roughly hour-long intervals by the pilots or, if equipped, the CPDLC data link systems on board the aircraft.
At Weeds, Los Angeles,
3215 United 123 United 1231 over.
United 1231, roger.
Spit it out, buddy.
We had no data link, so for this trip, we'd rely on HF. HF, which stands for high-frequency radios, are more powerful than the VHF radios we use to communicate with ATC over land. HF technology is quite old and directs radio waves up into the ionosphere, where they travel extremely long distances. These are essentially shortwave radios. Although HF has tremendous range, they lack clarity and are subject to interference and background noise. The usable HF frequencies also change throughout the day relative to the position of the sun on the horizon. Another item we lacked on board was a selective calling device. Pilots know this as cell call. Cell call uses DTMF signaling, which is basically the sound a touch-tone phone makes. When an aircraft has cell call capability, the crew can turn the HF volume all the way down and ATC can initiate communications by pinging aircraft's cell call code. We didn't have this capability, so the ride was spent listening to endless chatter and cell call signaling. Not fun. Normally on this run, we land in Honolulu in the afternoon, but the delayed departure from Victorville pushed everything forward, so we'd land after dark. In stark contrast to the 2020 lockdown, as of September of 21, things in Waikiki are back to the typical chaos. John and I checked into the outrigger, grabbed a quick bite to eat, and turned in for the night. The second day of flying with these Brisbane returns is definitely the tougher of the days. By our standards, it's not terrible with two roughly 5-hour legs and a fuel stop in Majuro, but the trips are planned to arrive Brisbane within a 4-hour window of our commercial departure home due to the Australian border restrictions associated with COVID. Heading this window means scheduling a landing slot in Majuro in the late morning, which in turn means we head out of Honolulu around 9 a.m. We got out to the airplane on time and started taking fuel. In Honolulu, we get handled by an FBO, which normally handles fancy business jets, but because of our size, they park us on a remote stand out past the cargo ramp.
We have food and drink. About 4 hours and 45 minutes over to Majuro today, so pretty quick ride, not too bad.
Okay, clear to Majuro via OPG3, Choco transition 5000 400 and 10 on departure heading 155, departure frequency 118.3 and 2613.
It's nice when we actually have the fucking database, even though there's only like 5 fixes. Alright, you got all this stuff in already. Sweet.
We pushed back, lit the fires, picked up our HF assignments, and taxied out to runway 8 right for departure. 8 right and 26 left is commonly known as the reef runway in Honolulu. This is because the 12,000-foot-long runway was built on a man-made reef. When I decided to produce Cockpit Casual, my vision was for a different kind of aviation and travel video series that focused on telling each story in an entertaining format, which involves speeding up long flight segments to keep things moving. That said, over the last few months, I've received multiple requests for a real-time departure video. Well, if there was ever a departure worthy of a real-time video, the reef runway departure from Honolulu is it. With that in mind, this episode will play out to the 8-right departure in real time. Enjoy.
Thank you.